Hello beauties, we're back at it again with another brow threading tutorial. I already started off with brushing her and trimming her a little bit and applying the cornstarch on her. So we are definitely going to give her a brow transformation. She has a lot of brows, a lot of hair. So we're starting off with getting that line straight along the top. Now we're gonna have our client stretch so that it's more comfortable for her and so that I can see much better. We can absolutely use our thread as a brush to brush away their hairline or brush away any hair that's already been removed. Now here we get to perfect the lines. It's always best to take off anything that is not a part of the brow at all that's around and then perfect the line as you go. So now we're going to the opposite side. And in this part, I'm actually in front of her. For the brow on the right side, I was behind her, but for the left one, I'm in front of her just so that I can get a better visual. So now that we have the top more aligned than we had it before, we're just gonna brush away any excess hair that's already been removed. And we're gonna have our client stretch their skin top and bottom so that we can start to clean up the bottom portion of her brows. and we're not really arching her brow too much. We're just giving her a nice cleanup and a nice line. Arching involves thinning out a brow. And believe it or not, a lot of clients do request their brow to be thinned out, just for the arch, just for their arch to stand out a bit more. But with this client, we're just doing a nice, simple cleanup. Look at that, super smooth. And now we're going back with trimming. So you don't have to remove hair with the thread all the time. With trimming alone, you can go a long way. Side. Now we're just removing obvious hairs that just need to be removed. Getting the front part together. Now going towards the middle. I did do it in real time just to show you guys, you know, the speed of how I thread when I'm just perfecting an arch, when I really, really just want to get the brows as perfect as possible. I take my time, and I would say just take your time when you're threading, because one pull, especially if you're not paying attention, you can literally pull a whole line of a brow off. So you want to be careful. Thank you. stretching the forehead just to get the center part. You see how those little hairs, they can tend to make a brow messy, but the moment you remove them, boom, completely different change. And I love threading because you can go over an area as much as you have to just to get it perfect versus waxing. Once you wax once, you're really, really risking it waxing over an area again. That's when the skin lifting starts and your client won't notice it and you might not notice it either until about the next day. But with threading, you can go over an area as much as you have to. So there you are. See, she's not really arched, she's just cleaned up. But she still has a nice shape. Now here we're just trimming anything else that we have to trim, just perfecting everything. And there you have it, my client's brows are done. Thank you guys so much for watching. Please be sure to like and subscribe. Have a good one.